San Diego, California experienced a spillage of cold, hard cash from a bridge truck. And you know what? It led to a fun time for the individuals you're seeing in the video right next to me, and a not so fun time for authorities who are now threatening people who collected the money that spilled from a Brinks truck on the highway. Let's watch.
This is the most insane thing I've ever seen. Someone dropped money all over the freeway. San Diego has shut down. Literally, it has shut down. Look at the freeway right now. Oh my gosh. Literally everybody stopped on the freeway to get money off of the freeway. This is literally insane. This is insane. Oh my gosh.
Then we go to scissor now, baby.
The heck? Yo, the entire freeway just shut down. They threw money. He's gone.
Wow.
He's gone.
Say, like, I'm excited for her. Like, I'm excited. She's experiencing a lot of joy. I can understand why. Don't like collect the money and run, homegirl. What are you doing? But this is the problem with youth today, right? They don't even know how to take advantage of a good situation. It's like, why would you incriminate yourself by putting out that video? Collect the money and run. Yeah, that's right. I'm giving them bad advice. Okay, what would you do? What would you do? Okay, what, you're gonna pretend like you don't see all that cash on the freeway?
No.
What would you do?
I would stop and see how big the bills are. Okay, so if they're $1 bills, which we'll tell you what they are in a second. If they're $1 bills, I'd be like, no guys, now, especially if my family's in the car. Now, this is a time for a good lesson, okay? This is technically not our money, okay? So you don't go rushing in and do that. And plus, it's dangerous on the highway. We're gonna keep driving, okay? If they're $100 bills, time for a different lesson. Look, you don't want to look a gift horse in the mouth.
Yeah.
You know, if God sent you manna from heaven, you think God made a mistake? I'm kidding. Mostly, kind of. So look, technically, you're not supposed to take that money. It's not your money, and then the authorities might pursue her or anyone else.
They're definitely gonna pursue her,
yeah,
100%.
Because you clearly see your face on the video, and you're taking the money and then putting it in your pockets.
Don't spend too much at Sizzler.
On the other hand, though, let me just finish the thought.
Yeah.
If you did what Anna suggested and you just grabbed as much as you could and you didn't tape yourself doing that.
Very quietly.
And you're in the middle of the traffic jam.
Everyone's going nuts,
yeah,
right?
And you get back in your car and eventually the cars start going. Well, officer, I don't know what you're talking about. I was there, but there's nothing I could do about me being there. Do you have evidence of me getting out and
collecting the money?
No. I had my kids in the car. I told them, you don't do that unless it's $100 bills.
Exactly. I mean, I remember old school TYT, we showed one of these videos where you're asked to focus on one part of the video. And as you're focusing on that one part of the video, something else happens in the video that you just totally miss because you're so hyper focused on that one thing, right? I bring that up because, like, some of the videos will have like a moonwalking bear or something, right? While you're focusing on something completely different. And the reason why I bring that up is because in this instance, there's so much chaos that you don't wanna be her, right? You don't wanna be the one who's like, focus on me, focus on me. You wanna be like the quiet person in the background who's just collecting the cash, putting it in your pocket and quietly walking away. Yeah, I'm giving that advice. It is what it is. Listen. It's not their fault that the Brinks truck experienced a spillage.
100%.
Right?
And if you notice, everybody is like different ages and races. Yeah. And like, no, like, you're a middle-aged housewife, money's money.
She's the smartest one because she's not trying to draw attention to herself, but these damn kids are like pointing the camera at her and she's like, God damn it.
Yeah, she's like, gotta go.
Yeah. All right, so let's give you the backstory. What happened? California Highway Patrol Sergeant Curtis Martin told reporters that the truck had been headed from San Diego to an office of the Federal Deposit Insurance Corp. One of the doors popped open and the the bags of cash fell out, he said. One of the bags broke apart and there was cash all over the lanes. I just find it fascinating because if you've ever experienced one of these workers for Brinks, I mean, they are armed to the teeth, okay? Like they are ready to go. Anyone tries to rob them, they'll shoot you. Like they're, but oh yeah, oh, just that the door popped open and one of the bags flew out. Like it's just amazing. That's
oh yeah, they're ready to kill you over it, but we forgot to lock the door.
Yeah, it's amazing.
That's a precaution I probably would have taken.
Also, they're issuing a threat to anyone who collected some of the cash.
Of course.
Which by the way was mostly $1 and $20 bills. Yeah. I'm not turning down a $20 bill. Hell, I'm not turning down a $1 bill. I will stop and pick up a $1 bill every time. Anyway, here's what the authorities are saying. If you found money on the freeway, it is not your money, Martin told local news station KCRA. It belongs to the FDIC and this armored truck and the bank. It needs to be returned. Two people were arrested at the scene and the California Highway Patrol and the FBI said Friday that anyone who took money needs to return it within 48 hours in order to avoid a potential criminal charge.
Okay, here's what I have to say to that. Let them go!
Totally.
Let them go!
Totally.
Hey, listen, man, they're not the ones who made the Brinks Bank thing fall out of the truck. You're gonna go prosecute those people? No way, man. We just did how many stories on today's show about people not getting prosecuted for terrible things. And you're gonna go prosecute these people just because it's the bank's money, right? No, 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 no. Let them go.
Listen, there is clearly one role for police in this country. Is it to protect citizens or is it to protect private property?
Yeah, and it's a great point, and especially when that property is a bank's property, then all of a sudden the cops are like lock and load. Okay, we're letting people go run wild because people hurt our feelings and Blue Lives Matter and all that stuff. But a bank's money? Whoa! Wait! We're gonna track down everyone who took $7 from that highway, and we're gonna go get them. It's a giant waste of people's time. Okay, so hey, if you're gonna be negligent, you're gonna be negligent.
So. I'm not a superstitious person, except in some ways I am. We've talked about this before. And I do think that karma in one way or the other happens, it exists. Mm-hmm. And I'll give you an example from something that happened recently near my home. So one day as I'm taking my dog out for a walk, on the side of our building, I noticed that there's a bunch of like trash, right? What appears to be trash. And it's trash from a store nearby, okay, a retail store. And it's very obvious that someone had shoplifted, probably like grabbed a bunch of stuff and ran out because the trash was the, you know, the stuff that they put on the clothing so it doesn't get stolen, like the device.
No, oh, yeah.
That had been ripped off. There were like, there was just all this stuff that made it clear that a person had shoplifted and they got rid of all the like stuff that prevents the shoplifting. And I got really mad, right? Because it's like, I don't like that kind of stuff.
Okay, yeah, shoplifters, we don't like that kind of stuff.
No, go.
You're terribly naughty.
Be smarter, don't throw that stuff like on the side of my building. It makes me feel a little scared. Like, I don't know, I just didn't like it.
Oh, right? I see.
Go
oh,
home and do that. Don't do it at my home. Don't go do it at your home. You get what I'm saying? That's my point.
Okay.
No, because you feel like, oh, like there was a criminal here who did criminal things, like right here on the side.
But Anna, as we talked about earlier in the show, I got news for you. There's criminals everywhere.
No, I know.
You get one of those apps and you'll see there's like 30 robberies in your neighborhood every day.
I walk by, like I purposely, listen, I walk out the back of my building to avoid my neighbers. So like the likelihood.
I thought you were gonna say avoid criminals. No, to avoid the neighbors.
But that's the thing. Now the criminals have ruined it for me because now I'm like super careful about like having to avoid criminals when I walk through the back.
This is Anna's daily routine. Criminals or neighbors, criminals or neighbors.
Oftentimes I go with the criminals, you know? But anyway, no, but to go back to my theory or whatever on karma or my evidence for karma. You know what else I found in that pile of garbage? A $50 bill.
Ooh. Nice. Yeah. By the way, let's note for the record that you looked through the pile.
Okay. I had to investigate.
She's a journalist. She had to investigate.
What, you're just gonna like leave it there? No, yeah. You wanna know what happened.
So did Anna and I do the right thing or wrong thing? Why did I say Anna and I? Because I have a very similar story. We went to a football game recently, the Chargers-Browns game. And I saw a $20 bill on the floor as we walked out. It was outside, it wasn't in the stadium. Now there's tons and tons of people there, but there was no one around that $20 bill because it was starting to wean out as we got further away from the stadium. And so I took it, right? And because the next person is going to take it. And it's impossible to find the person who dropped it. If I saw the person dropping it, that's a no-brainer. I give it to them right away.
Of course.
Right? But it's clear that nobody knows whose bill it is. My wife thinks, no, that's immoral.
What?
Yeah, she thinks, don't take it.
What are you going to do? You're just going to leave it on the floor?
I don't know.
No, you did the right thing. Don't worry. Sleep easy.
Should we do a poll?
I mean, we don't have a poll ready for that. But I'm guessing that most people would do the same thing. Again, like if it's in a wallet, like if I see a wallet on the ground, I'm going to see if there's ID and I'm going to return everything to the person who dropped it.
Yeah, that has happened
and I have done that.
Yeah,
but,
of course.
But if we're talking about a random bill, like whether it's $20, $50, $1, who cares? And there's no way of figuring out who it belongs to. And especially in the environment we're talking about, we're talking about a stadium, we're talking about thousands of people. You're not going to figure out who that belongs to. It is your duty to pick it up and put it in your pocket.
Yeah, I mean, what lesson does it teach your son that you were with? Well, if you saw somebody drop it and you don't return to him, it teaches a terrible lesson about not being nice to others. If there's no one else around and there's no way of determining whose money it is and you walk by it purposely, tell him not to pick it up, then you're teaching him to be a sucker.
100%.
All right, obviously people will disagree. But I've had the same thing happen. A wallet, I see the ID.
Yeah.
You toss the ID so no one can identify it. No, I'm kidding. I've returned wallets too. Of course,
yeah.
Be a decent human being, but don't be a schmuck. Okay, that's the lesson of this entire story.
Exactly.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.